Hey there all, today we'll be taking a look at the Arai Tour X4 Adventure Helmet. If you want a helmet for your more adventurous trips, then the Arai Tour X4, known as the Arai XD4 in the US, will be right there with you. You can wear this helmet in three different configurations, including with the peak and the visor, with just the peak and a pair of goggles since the visor is removable, or even without the peak and just the visor if you want to hit mostly the road. So you can already start to get an idea of how this helmet can range from a street touring helmet to one suited to adventure riding as well. The helmet will be coming in at a recommended retail price of about 650 euros or around 720 US dollars, so you are definitely getting a premium helmet here with all the options. At this price range, the Arai Tour X4 will be competing with the Showy Hornet ADV, the AGV AX9, and the Schubert E1. Just a reminder, if you'd like to check out some more of our reviews, road tests, and guides, to head to our YouTube channel, hit subscribe, and allow notifications to keep up to date on all the latest motorcycle gear. First, let's start with the Tour X4's material. The Arai Tour X4's shell is made of Arai's complex fiber laminate construction, which is Arai's own in-house shell material that gives the helmet strength and impact flexibility. This also gives you a fairly decent weight helmet, since when we weighed the Tour X4, we got a weight of 1,620 grams in a size M, with all the extras, so that's pretty average, though a little bit more on the heavier end of the spectrum, but still not too bad. This helmet also comes in 5 shell sizes, which is pretty astounding since that's quite a lot for most helmets, and it's going to be safe since it's ECE, DOT, and SNELL certified. You'll also notice this helmet has a very round profile, which is what Arai is known for, since they try to focus on the helmet glancing off on any surface during an impact. Now, looking at the ventilation on this helmet, you're getting plenty. For example, in the chin here, you've got a switch that controls this bank of 12 intake vents, which should be really good since you're going to get plenty of air in through there. If you need, you also have an internal switch to close the bottom set of vents if you don't want dust getting in and hitting your mouth while still allowing you to demist the visor. And the brow, obviously, you've got these two classic Arai visor vents, and further up, you have these two vents up here, which you can open and close individually with those two switches there. While we're here, you've got these two exhausts in the back there, which are removable in case you need to clean the helmet, and they'll let hot air out through there. And to help with that even further, you've got these two side vents on either side of the helmet, and you've got this exhaust here underneath the neck roll there. So plenty of ventilation on this helmet. Onto the visor now, and we're getting a pinlock prepared visor with the additional insert in the box. So this means that even in the worst fogging conditions, your visor should stay as clear as it ever was. Looking at the peak, it's been designed by Arai in such a way as to prevent lifting while you're riding and instead forcing all that air into these two brow vents on the top of the helmet. So you're going to get even more cooling. If you want to remove the visor of the peak, or the peak even, it's pretty straightforward, though you will need a screwdriver. Though then again, from a full face helmet, this seems a little bit unnecessary since it's quite expensive and you still need a screwdriver. But given that this helmet is so versatile, that's a little bit more forgivable since it's meant for so many applications. So that's the peak coming off. You can already see the plastic screws. You've got 4 total, 2 on either side. And you can also use this helmet without the peak if you need. This will be its profile. And if you want to just take off the visor after the peak, all you have to do is lift it off and it'll come off very easily. If you did want to ride this helmet with just the visor, then you also get these two additional side panels in the box, which will be what you'll want to use instead of the peak side panels since they're designed slightly differently. To put the visor back on, all you need to do is make sure it lines up on the inside. You can just screw everything back on very easily. Now, let's take a look at the Tour X4's liner. To start with, it's Arai's dry, cool liner, so it's removable, washable, and moisture wicking. However, you can really see that Arai really went in on the comfort here to try and justify that high price mark. First, this helmet features Arai's facial contour system, or FCS for short, which means that cheek pads have foam spring supports to more effectively have a snug fit without giving you too much pressure. To further enhance this helmet's comfort, the cheek pads and the temple of the comfort liner have 5mm peel-away pads, so if you need a bit more space in the helmet, you can have it. To take out the liner is fairly easy and straightforward. First, all you need to do is slide out the cheek pads. They snap out and slide out from the chin strap. You can see the double D-ring chin strap there. These cheek pads are thick and look comfortable for a good fit. For the rest of the liner, there are 4 snaps on the comfort liner to undo to get them out. What's nice about the liner is it has multiple levels to help with comfort and ventilation. The only unfortunate thing is we have no EPS grooves in this helmet, but we'll see how well it ventilates out on the road given the number of vents on this helmet. This helmet also has enough space in the cheeks for a communication system. So let's see how this helmet does out on the road. Just a quick reminder for our road test setup. On the left, we've got a screen showing the helmet's internal temperature in degrees Celsius through a thermometer placed in the central ventilation channel. In the middle is a decibel meter showing our readings based on a microphone near our rider's ear. On the right is a phone showing the day's average wind speed, and in the middle on the dash is our rider's speed and the external temperature. We tested the Arai Tour X4 on a cool day with the sun out, so we could also gauge the effectiveness of the Arai's peak. During our road test, our rider rode on long stretches of highway at about 130 kilometers per hour. The day's wind speed ranged between 110 kilometers per hour and 130 kilometers per hour. For ventilation, the Tour X4's many vents did not let this helmet down, since the helmet's internal temperature was about 8 degrees, while it was 7 degrees Celsius outside, so that's a very good 1 degree Celsius difference. For noise, this helmet was also very quiet with an average of about 102 decibels. Our rider found the helmet to be very comfortable and performed similarly to the Shoei Hornet ADV. Since we rode on a sunny day, he also found that the peak blocked out the sun effectively and didn't lift too much when looking ahead. He ultimately commented that the Tour X4 was slightly quieter than the Hornet ADV, but it was also slightly less comfortable, though both still did well in this category, with the Arai Tour X4's intermediate oval head fit, double D-ring chin strap, and emergency release cheek pads. Now, let's see how the Tour X4 ranked. For material, since the shell comes in 5 shell sizes and the material is Arai's laminate construction, that's a strong 4 stars. For weight, since this is an adventure helmet, it came out about a heavier 1600 grams, giving this helmet 3 stars for weight. For the visor, since you're getting a large field of view and the visor comes pinlock prepared with the pinlock insert in the box, that's a decent 4 stars. For ventilation, this helmet did well, with about a 1 degree difference to the outside temperature, so that's another 4 stars and a big improvement over the Shoei Hornet ADV. For noise as well, this helmet did well with an average of about 102 decibels, giving the Tour X4 3 stars for noise. This helmet was also comfortable, giving the Tour X4 4 stars for comfort. This will bring the Tour X4 to a total of 3.5 stars, with each star costing 30 euros per star. So, this is a half star better than the Shoei Hornet ADV, but the Tour X4 is about 4 euros per star more, so it's a bit more in terms of value for money than the Shoei, and the main gripe would be about the visor and peak removal systems. If you'd like to purchase the Arai Tour X4, then make sure to check out our website at championhelmets.com, where we have a lowest price guarantee and bundle deals. So, that's all for the Arai Tour X4 here at Champion Helmets today. If you like the video, make sure to subscribe to our channel and let us know your experiences, comments, and questions of the Tour X4 down below. I'm Sebastian from Champion Helmets, and thanks for watching.